Not a single scene has been shot, but a miniseries about Jack Kennedy is already drawing fire from the late president's supporters. The History Channel project was created by Joel Surnow, an unabashed conservative and George Bush supporter who helped produce the Fox drama 24 and is an acquaintance of Rush Limbaugh. Liberal filmmaker Robert Greenwald obtained a copy of the script and has put up a web video denouncing the movie The Kennedys, using the likes of former JFK advisor Ted Sorensen.
This one-sided right-wing script suffer from a vindictive, malicious approach.
Greenwald's campaign is reminiscent of the conservative complaints 7 years ago against the CBS movie The Reagans, which portrayed the 40th president, among other things, as insensitive to AIDS. CBS caved to the pressure and aired the film on its Showtime channel.
One thing is clear about the script obtained by Greenwald. It includes some made-up scenes, such as Jack asking his brother Robert what he does when he's horny and saying that if he doesn't have sex with new women every couple of days, he gets migraines. So is it fair to attack a film that hasn't even been made? I spoke earlier with Robert Greenwald from Los Angeles. Robert Greenwald, welcome.
Thank you.
Why have you launched this preemptive strike against a movie that hasn't even begun shooting yet?
Well, it's a television miniseries in which Joel Surnow deliberately distorts historical fact with the intent for political agenda. The reason we've done it now is, in fact, this is the time that you can affect things by getting the truth out there. Once a miniseries is finished and edited, it's very hard to correct all of the political agendas and all of the reasoning that makes absolutely no sense. And that's the reason, by the way, it's right. Not me. Five historians have come forward.
Let me jump in here because we invited somebody from the History Channel to appear in this program. The History Channel declined, but I do have a statement. In part, it says, our in-house group of historians have not vetted or, for that matter, seen any scripts yet. The scripts are in early draft form and are currently being annotated and revised every day. There are no final versions. The miniseries will be historically accurate and based on the work of multiple noted scholars. So basically, the channel seems to be saying you're firing your ammunition here a little early.
Well, the channel's been saying many things, and I wish that they would save their energy, stop attacking me. Look, everyone makes a mistake. They made a serious mistake by turning this miniseries over to someone with a political agenda. Now it's time to reevaluate. They gave an interview in the New York Times. They cited historians whose work they were using, including David Talbot. David Talbot not only was never contacted, he released yesterday a scathing statement about the distortions, number one. And number two, Howard, as you well know, the cover-up is often worse than the mistake. The History Channel is not telling the truth. They are using this screenplay, they're going out and they're offering it to actors with millions of dollars attached
in fairness,
to try to get them to be in the screenplay.
In fairness, that remains to be seen and scripts do
change.
No,
it doesn't remain to be seen.
Well, you're saying this is going to be the final version. We're not going to see the final
version
until 2011.
I'm not saying it's the final version. I'm saying that they cannot say that this version is not a version that they are using. They're going to actors and they're saying to actors, be in this movie, here's the screenplay, here's several million dollars. They're not saying it's a work in development, which is a term in Hollywood. They're not saying we're doing a project, are you interested? They're saying, here, will you be in it? That's hard, firm evidence.
Speaking of that New York Times article you mentioned, Stephen Cronish, who is the screenwriter on The Kennedys, was quoted as saying, next year when it's done and it's on the air, people want to criticize it, so be it. But at this stage of evolutionary development, it seems that Greenwald's agenda becomes all the more obvious. So they are saying that you are coming at this from a liberal perspective and you've got your own agenda.
Of course they're saying that, but what they're not saying is we have a team of all-star historians, five of them who've come forward, several of them strong critics of the Kennedy family, and they have been damning and indicting for the fact that what this miniseries does is it pursues a political agenda. And by the way, there's nothing wrong with pursuing a political agenda. The problem is they're doing it under the guise and imprint of something called the History Channel.
Exactly.
That's
now,
a serious mistake.
The specific dialogue in some of these scenes obviously were invented, but we now know that President Kennedy had a series of extramarital affairs. You're not disputing that, are you?
Absolutely not. And as David Talbot says, it's fair game to introduce and talk about those in a manner that's historically responsible. And one of the painful things, and you'll see it in our film at StopKennedySmears.com, is the historian saying, sadly, with pain, why are they distorting in this way that's not necessary? Look, I had lots of disagreements with Kennedy on policy. That's fair debate to have.
Sure.
It's not fair to trash and demean him for a political agenda.
Now, Stephen Cronish, the screenwriter, also told the New York Times that this is not a documentary, it's a dramatization. Now, I am not a fan of that genre. They use real names and historical events, and many people assume that it's based on fact. But that's hardly unusual these days, and yet you're jumping on this film or film in progress as if no one has ever done one of these docudramas before.
No, I myself came from the commercial world. I made over 50 television movies and miniseries. I'm intimately familiar with this form, and I have never in my career seen anything like this where it's character assassination pretending to be a miniseries. It has 12 to 20 sex scenes. If Kennedy had time to do nothing else, it seems. And most importantly, Howard, I don't care what your politics are. This is a below-the-belt trashing of a president of the United States, not on policy, but character assassination.
Well, I am shocked that a movie would include a lot of sex scenes in order to get people to watch. All right,
no,
Robert,
I understand. That's not the point. The point is going after him character with a political agenda.
Robert Greenwald, thanks very much for joining us.
My pleasure.